Welcome to Pastor's Chat today. We're looking at the book of Jude, a wonderful book that exhorts us, that encourages us, but also it is a book of warning, and especially a book of warning about the apostate teachers who will enter the church and destroy it. The church, someone said, is only one generation away from extinction. Only one generation. And if we're not careful, the next generation of young people will grow up allowing false teachers to come in and destroy the body of Jesus Christ. It was already happening in the first century. Now, Jude, of course, is the writer of this little book, the half-brother of Jesus, and he is writing to the saints that we already talked about, those who are called, those who are sanctified, those who are preserved. And so he's made that very clear. And yesterday we talked about that mercy, peace, and love that we all can have in Christ Jesus. Now, verse 3 and 4 kind of kicks off the book and tells us the setting behind what he's going to write in the following verses. Beloved. So he calls these saints, these wonderful believers that he's writing to, beloved. He loves them. He cares for them. And he says, while I was very diligent to write to you concerning our common salvation, I found it necessary to write to you, exhorting you to contend earnestly for the faith which was once for all delivered to the saints. For certain men have crept in unnoticed, who long ago were marked out for this condemnation, ungodly men, who turn the grace of our God into lewdness and deny the only Lord God and our Lord Jesus Christ. And so Jude is exhorting this church. Now, this word exhort here is a word that in the Greek would have been used by an army commander or a leader of the military, and he would have exhorted his troops to stand up against the enemy, to fight. And so this is a strong word that is not just trying to encourage them, it's like a command. Wake up, be alert. You know, we have to be alert, be sober, be vigilant, for your adversary, the devil, goes about like a roaring lion, deceiving, devouring whom he may. We must realize the people of God are armies. They are an army. They're a spiritual army. We are in spiritual warfare against the enemy of this world, who is, of course, the devil. And of course, the flesh and the lust of the flesh and all those things that go with it. And so we're being warned here that we need to earnestly contend for the faith. Now, what's being attacked is the foundations of our faith. In Psalms chapter 11, the scripture says, if the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? Now, for years as I read that verse, it was like, wow, you just throw up your hands, because if the foundations of the church, the foundations of our beliefs, foundations of our Christian faith is destroyed, what can the righteous do? Well, they just throw up our hands. No, that's not what he's actually saying there, I believe, in Psalm 11. If the foundations are destroyed, what can the righteous do? Yes, there's something we can do. We can stand up. We can speak up. I'm terribly concerned about our country, our nation today, because it appears the foundations of our country have been destroyed. The foundations of our churches, the foundations of our faith, the doctrines of true belief and faith in Jesus Christ have been destroyed. What can the righteous do? Well, we can do what Jude tells the church to do in the first century. Stand up for the faith. Proclaim the faith. That's what we're trying to do with this Pastor's Chat every day. We're not trying to fight and argue with everything that comes along and all the issues that are facing the church. But if there's one thing we have to be willing to do, and that's why we're studying this book of Jude, we have to be willing as believers to realize we are at war. There is something happening to destroy the faith of your children and the faith of that has built this country into the country that it is. We stand up. We do what we need to do. We earnestly, diligently contend, not be contentious, but contend for the faith. And so that's what Jude is writing about here. I hope you'll join the army of God. You've already been recruited. You are called to stand up. You're called to live for Christ. You're called to make a difference. You're called to be a peculiar people according to the scripture. May the Lord help us to do that today. I love you. I love this country. I love my children, my grandchildren, and I believe we can do something. Let's read our scriptures. Let's pray. Let's stand up. Let's speak up. Let's know what we believe, and may God help us today. God bless, and you have a wonderful, wonderful day.